Now, the latest research on memory says that 50% of what we talk about in our past isn't even the truth. So we make stuff up about the past. In other words, people are reliving a life that they didn't even have just to reaffirm that they can't change, right? So then what's the significance of this? Where you place your attention is where you place your energy, period.
Yes.
So then the stronger the emotion that you have to some problem or condition or person in your life, the more you're paying attention to them. So they captured your attention. So you're giving your power away to that person, right? Because they're capturing your attention. So then there's an energetic connection to every person, everything in your past, present reality has your energy connected to it. So now, this is the significance. When a person really decides to be defined by a vision of the future instead of the memory of the past, the hardest part about it is all of a sudden becoming conscious and not making the same unconscious choice. So then, if you lower the volume to your frustration, to your hatred, to your anger, if you truly knew how to do that, if you lowered the volume to that emotion, you would take your attention off that person, which means you would begin to break those energetic bonds, and now you're taking your power back.
Yes.
You're calling energy back to you, and we've measured this. And all of a sudden, it builds this bigger electromagnetic field around the person's body. That's energy to heal. That's energy to create a new future with, right? And then, if you didn't want to lower the volume to the emotion, then just take your attention off the person. And every time you take your attention off the person, if you became conscious of that, you wouldn't feel the emotion.
Mm.
Now the body, though, has been addicted to that emotion,
right?
Because you're using that person to reaffirm your addiction to hatred or frustration. And if that person died, you find another one. So then here you go now. So now you're in a position now where you begin to lower the volume to that emotion, and the body's going, wait a second, you've been doing this for the last 20 years, and all of a sudden you're just going to stop hating? And the body says, well, I've been conditioned this way, and conditioning is based on the past. So when the body feels the lack of that emotion, just like a drug addict, it says, hey, you're off schedule here. So now the body starts influencing the mind to think about experiences that are embossed in the brain that are based on that emotion. So the emotion now is causing you to think in the past. If we teach a person then how to trade that frustration or that hatred for an elevated emotion, and they'll say, yeah, but you know, it was my ex's fault, or I got betrayed by my partner in business. Yeah, we know that. Okay, so let's take your partner in business, or take your ex, let's duct tape them, put them in a cannon, and shoot them to the moon. Now what are you gonna do? Sooner or later, you gotta reckon with yourself and change, right? So then, teach a person then how to trade that emotion for an elevated emotion. Now,
trade the emotion for an elevated emotion.
Right. So you're going to give that up, and you're going to practice feeling gratitude for, as an example.
Yes.
And the person says, well, I can't feel gratitude. And I say, absolutely you can, because you don't practice feeling it. You practice spending most of your time feeling hatred and frustration. So now it's going to take a little time to cause that heart of you to bloom, or your heart of yours to bloom. Once they're able to feel even the smallest measure of gratitude, where they start feeling appreciation, thankfulness. Gratitude, it's emotional signature. When you get something, when you're receiving something, when something has happened to you, or when something is happening to you, you say thank you because you're receiving something. So the emotional signature of gratitude means the event has already happened, or it's happening to you. So the moment you open your heart and you feel gratitude, well, that emotion then is telling the body that the experience has already occurred, and the thought then can make it into the body because it's consistent with the thought. So now you're beginning to program the autonomic nervous system into a very specific destiny. You gotta maintain that modified state of mind and body your entire day, independent of the conditions in your outer environment, independent of your body's cravings of those emotions and habituations, and independent from time. And if you can, get ready, because something weird or unusual, some synchronicity, some coincidence, some opportunity is going to land in your lap, and you didn't have to go and get it.
Yes.
It came to you. Now you're the vortex of creation. So if you say to me, well, I was feeling gratitude, but then there was traffic, or my coworker sent me a nasty email, then I would say, oh my God, You mean you're allowing your environment, your outer environment, to control how you feel and think?
Mm-hmm.
You're back to the unconscious program that you're the victim to your life.
You got it.
But when you start producing those outcomes in your life, you're going to pay attention to what you did inside of you. And you're going to believe more that you're the creator of your life and less of the victim of your life. We're changing our brain and body to live in that future present reality so that you feel connected to a future instead of the past. And when you're connected to the past, you're looking for it. And if you're looking for it, you're separate from it. If you're being it, then there's a complete change in energy. And nobody changes until they change their energy. And when you change your energy, you change your life. Mm. After 8,500 brain scans, I can tell you that you and I are at our absolute best when we get beyond ourselves. That is the elegant moment where we're free enough to create without any encumbrances. When people start reaching this moment, my goodness, they're overcoming themselves. And now they're at that perfect place to create. And my definition of creation is when I forget about myself.
Wow.
That's when you're free. So some people can do it because they've practiced it. Other people can't get beyond the addiction of a certain emotion. That means their body is still their mind.
Yes.
So then if you're sitting in a meditation and your body's throwing the kitchen sink at you and saying, Ed, you're a loser, you're never gonna change, this is too hard, why don't you quit? And you're aware that that's your body doing that, and you say to your body, we're gonna sit here, and we're gonna sit in this fire, and I'm gonna keep applying the formula, and your brain starts running to all the emails you have to do, and
yes.
You become aware of that, and you return back to the present moment,
mm-hmm.
and you tell the body it's no longer the mind, that you're the mind. Now your will is getting greater than that program, and there's a liberation of energy. And every time you do that, that's a victory.
Mm.
And you teach people.
Every time you do that, that's a victory.
That's
when
a
your
victory.
Mind tells the body, I'm in charge.
When you say to your, when you want to get up and you want to quit and you go, oh, now that's my body, bring it back.
Okay.
And now you're taming the animal. The body is the animal. And you're like a dog, you sit. And if you keep doing this, you're climbing on top. And the body finally acquiesces. It finally says, I'm not going anywhere. And then, boom, there's this liberation of energy. What's the side effect? Joy. Person's heart just automatically opens up, and every time they do that, those victories add up. There's no such thing as a bad meditation. There's only overcoming yourself. And when you sit in the fire and you work with that, people say to me, why do you meditate every morning? I say, because if I can overcome myself in the morning, the rest of my day is easy. It's easy.
True?
Because that's what it's about. You master yourself, you master your life.
Yes.
And so then all the chatter in your head that you listen to all day long, that is called the default mode network in the brain. Mm. Our research shows that shuts off. Not just shuts off during the meditation. Mm. It stays shut off for the rest of the day. So the critic in your head that's telling you this will never happen, you don't have enough time, that there's no voice there.
Mm-hmm.
So you just have a clear flow on where you're going, and you trust yourself more.
Yes.
So then when you start practicing creating that brain and heart coherence, you can believe in a future that you can't see or experience with your senses yet, but you've thought about enough times in your mind that it's actually, there's physical evidence in your brain to look like it's already happened. And you can begin to understand, you can select a new potential in the quantum field, and every day emotionally embrace that future reality to such a degree that your body begins to believe it's living in that future reality in the present moment, and you're signaling new genes and new ways to change your body to look like it's already happened. Now think about this. If there's physical evidence by thought alone in your brain and body to look like your wealth or your future has already happened, it's already happened.
Already happened.
And you're already it. So it's not about your wealth. It's not about your health. It's not about your freedom. It's who you become. So then as you overcome, you become someone else. And so most people don't understand that. That the truth is that every time you overcome yourself a little bit more, the side effect is that you love yourself a little bit more. And so now self-love is no longer about pleasure or having a car. It's something that you're cultivating within you. So then imagine, we have research to show, and this is such a duality, that when you start seeing the brain start synchronizing, getting coherent, the front of the brain and the back of the brain, the two hemispheres coming together, and we can say to scientists that come and study our work, oh, watch this, Ed's gonna pop. What do you mean? Just watch, this is gonna be good. And all of a sudden you see this brain going into this kind of psychic union, the heart blows wide open, you see coherence going on, and you look around at that person, and there's tears running down their face. Imagine feeling so whole that it's impossible to want. I mean, how can you want when you're whole? Because you feel like you already have it. Now, when you reach that point, that's when the magic happens, because now you are worthy to receive. And the universe only gives us what we think we're worthy of receiving.